Hi, hello, good evening, friends. Warm welcome, one and all, to Super 25 2.0, India's largest online stock traders conference. Friends, today we are in the 8th session of our seminar series. We are coming up with the title Using Open Interest to Detect Large Position Buildup. The speaker for today is Mr. Rajesh Srivastava from Bangalore, a very good friend of mine. We have worked together, we have learned together. I've also learned some of the options concepts from him. He has been in the financial markets for close to 20 years now. Mainly his focus is on OI. He is one of the well-known OI experts that I know. Rajesh, I think you are speaking in our forum for the second or third time, probably.
Third time, yeah.
Okay, sounds good, Rajesh. I hope our association prospers more. Well, on behalf of all the audience here, I extend my warm welcome into the program.
Thank you, Ashok. And it is always an honor, you know, to speak at your event. And Traders Gurukul don't need any more introduction. So is there any wait time, Ashokji, like 5 minutes or something? Or we can start.
You can start. We are already on time. Take off, sir. Bye bye.
Okay, thank you. Okay, thank you everyone for joining in. And as always, we will learn something new today. And again, there is a flow of session. So in case if we miss anything during the flow, you can ask the question here. Or at the end, you will have Ashok's email ID, my email ID, my phone number. You can drop in questions. Okay. So what we'll do in the last two sessions, we have seen two type of uses of open interest. Today we will learn one more use of open interest. Open interest is an ocean. You can use it at various, you know, places with various logics. We'll see one more logic today. Someone has a question. Screen not visible. Baibabji, I think people can see. Ashok, you can see my screen, right?
Rajesh, everyone can see any okay. Such key issues, I will address you. Okay, you proceed. Right.
Okay. So I will start with my introduction. People who is joining for the first time, it's more for them. But people who knows me, thank you for trusting one more time. So today we will learn proactive decision making using open interest. Okay. Now this is about me. I'm Rajesh Srivastava. I started trading around 2000. It's been 21 years in the market. I've been using open interest, various modules, and an option pricing based trades. I'm conducting online training for last 6 years, and live trading for my training participants. So what are we going to do? Let's see. Let's start with a quote from Stephen Pugh. While data relies on logic and reasoning, decisions are often made based on emotions. What we'll do today, we'll use logic to make a decision out of the data. Okay. But what we will not do today, we'll not make use of any emotions. Everything should be a data-driven decision. There should not be a discretionary decision. Okay. So what is open interest? I mean, we're going to use a new logic where we will apply open interest. But before that, what is open interest? See, there are volumes written about open interest. I'll keep it, you know, as simple as it can. But according to Investopedia, open interest is total number of outstanding derivative contract, okay, such as option or future that has not been settled for an asset. Okay, let me make it very, very, very easy for you. Okay, see, in equity, there is no deadline. If you have bought something, you can sell it whenever you want it to sell. There is no deadline. But in derivative, there is a deadline. Okay. If you have purchased something, that must be closed. I mean, derivative also allow you to sell something. Okay. Equity don't allow. Even though, I mean, if you don't own something in equity market, you cannot sell. But in derivative, you can do that. So the big difference between equity and derivative is, A derivative trade must have two leg of transaction. First leg, buy or sell. And the second leg, if you have bought, you must have to sell. Or if you have sold, you must have to buy. So every derivative trade will definitely mandatorily will have two transactions. Okay, if it is clear till here. Now, unless you execute the second transaction, the trade remains open. Okay, and those trades will be called part of, those trades will be part of the open interest calculation. It is clear till here. You can put in question if you have any question. So I'm repeating one more time. In equity, you don't have to close a trade. You have freedom to keep it open as long as you want. But in derivative, the trade must be closed by a given date. In India, we have the expiry day. For example, last Thursday of the month. So unless you close, that trade remains open, and that trade will be a part of the open interest. Okay. Now, the total open interest does not count, and total every buy or sell contract. Instead, open interest provide a more accurate picture of option trading or future trading and wherever money flows into the future. Okay. The point is, it does not say, see, a stock have, let's say, for example, 10 lakh open interest. Okay. Or say 5 lakh contracts in open interest. That 5 lakh does not mean everything is a bought or everything is sold. It could be mix of book together. Okay. That we have to decode. And that piece we have learned in the previous session through the Gurukul only, trading Gurukul. But what open interest is telling you, these trades are currently open. It could be buy, it could be sell. But another underlying message from that is, now there is a money flow into it. If there is high number of open interest, there is a high number of money flow into it, right? Right? Now, we can also say open interest is measure of market activity. There is a high number of open interest, high activities going on in the stock. Okay. See, you can see tomorrow and the number of contracts changing, not in terms of percentage, but in terms of number of contract. ITC always have lower number of contract compared to, you know, Bajaj Finance or State Bank of India or, you know, any other high liquid stock. So there is a higher activity. Okay. Little or no open interest means there is no opening position, or nearly all position have been closed. So towards the end of the series, you see less open interest. It does not mean people are not interested or the activities have gone down. It's just people have closed the positions. Okay. Okay. High open interest means there are many contracts still open. See a stock, for example, for example, if you see yesterday, you know, let me remember which stock had the highest open interest change, 12th May. Just a minute, guys. Okay, I'll let you put one stock. This is future. I'm putting largest to smallest. See, SBI had 4,000 lots of contract got added on 12th May. Today's date I'm not prepared, so I'm talking about yesterday. Well, what does it mean? High open interest means there are many contracts are still open. Now we cannot say SBI all contracts are like 4,000 got added, all are purchased or sold. It could be mixed. We can decode it. That's not a problem. Okay. But a high open interest means high interest by the market or high activity in the stock. Okay. Clear up to here? Clear? Okay. Someone written clear. Okay.
Yes.
Now, okay, let's see a high level interpretation. This is a very high level. It has to be drilled down further, but considering the limitation of time, and see, I just started saying open interest is an ocean, so we cannot discuss everything together, but at a higher level, you know, a long built up or a long, you know, addition into the stock. Usually you'll find, you know, price going up and the open interest going up. And see, this is at a higher level. It could happen that a stock has like was 10% up in the morning and 5% by closing it is 5%. No, this is still price up and the open interest up, but I cannot say long build up because stock has retraced 5% from the high. So that's a different calculation we have to see sometime next session whenever Ashok calls in. But for now, remember at the higher level, if price up, OI up, we will consider long built up. If price down, OI up, we will consider short built up. Okay. If price is also going down, OI also going down, it means someone has added a position earlier who is closing down his position and his OI is getting nullified. So we will say long unwinding is going on. And similarly, the other way, if price is going up, OI is coming down, we'll say somebody is closing their short position. And see, this is a very, very, very high level interpretation. This required at least 3 hours separately to discuss how to drill down to the further level. Okay. But this is the higher level. Now, why I'm teaching you? Because we are going to make use of open interest to a new logic this time. Okay. Okay. Now, what are we going to do today? See, you would have seen, you know, when a month start, a certain stock start moving and till expiry, the stock continue to move. Can we predict those stocks? Can we detect those stocks? Yes, we can. We can. No, let me show you something. Let me show you something. Just a minute. Huh? So we all know by now, open interest means, okay. Ashok, I'm putting Excel sheet. Open in lal path. Open interest means number of open trades. Okay. See, when the month started, this is, I'm talking about 38 March. Look at the date on my top. As lal path lab has huge position built up, and this is the last 3 months. You see, February, March, so January, February, March. Normally we don't get to see that kind of built up, but this month, when the month started, lal path lab had huge built up. Now what happened after that, we know. After the series ends, COVID was at the peak of it, like this destruction. Who was the only beneficial of the COVID destruction? Dr. Lal Path Lab. Now, can we detect this before the series start? Yes, we can detect this where the market is looking at or where the market is positioning at. But remember, I have said this in earlier sessions also. Whenever we talk about open interest, we have to talk two things together: detection and decoding. Now we have detected through the open interest that, okay, now today is 38th of the April, new series is starting, and Lal Path Lab has huge position built up. But we don't know, are these are long or short? I said earlier also, right? Open interest does not mean all are long or all are short. Open interest means there is a money flow into it, and we have to decode it in various methodology, right? Okay. So we knew there is a huge position built up. Now today we will learn how can we detect this kind of abnormalities or anomalies in built up. So now what are we going to do today? We are going to make use of open interest and find where the large players are positioning. Okay. Before I go to this methodology, any questions? Guys, you can drop in the questions here. I'll be more than happy to answer this. Okay, since no questions, right? Okay, clear. Thank you, Morgan. Number of buyer will be equal to seller. Yeah, so definitely will be equal to seller, but all buyer and seller does not get counted into open interest. Only the fresh trades, like if you are a first time buyer and somebody is a first time seller, get counted into the open interest. Okay, suppose I already have a long position, I'm closing my long, so I'm a seller and you are buying for the first time as a first leg of transaction, this will not be part of the open interest. Okay, so both of our transactions should be the first leg of transaction. And as I said, open interest from the grassroots need 3 hours separate session altogether. Okay, will you show the methodology to know the position long or so? Yeah, definitely. I said we cannot discuss only detection piece in silos. We have to discuss detection and decoding together. Remember, any type of application of open interest, two things has to go together: detection and decoding. See, here also we have detected, okay, that Dr. Lal Path Lab has huge position built up. See, it could have been a short also, so we have to decode it. I'll definitely show you how to decode this. Okay, where to see this data, sir? Madhu sir, I will teach you how to see this data. Okay, okay, let's move ahead. This is the example Amaraja battery. This is on the 38th of April before the day start. See Amaraja battery, when I compare the last 4 months, it was a regular day for this stock. But when this series started, the large players have already made their position. See, if I call you today and tell you, boss, I have an input. Government is coming out with the PLI scheme. What is PLI scheme? Production link incentive scheme. What will be your first reaction? You will go and create a position, right? This is what happened. See, the production link incentive scheme for batteries companies came just last Wednesday. But even before the series start, the large players have already created their position. This is the day of 31st. We will do this live today. How we will arrive to this data in incoming minutes. Okay. Buy battery stocks. Okay, let's not do recommendation on this. Okay. So the idea today, let's see on the very first day of the series. Okay, listen here carefully. Let's see on the very first day of the series, how many stock have abnormal position built up compared to the last 3 months. Okay. And remember, we are trying to find how many stocks have abnormal position built up to start the series compared to the last 3 months. Okay. And if something has really abnormal, see, for example, you know, let's take another stock. Let me show you another stock. Okay, sale.